Hello everyone, I am so excited to share with you today an absolutely amazing project to work on. What happens when you combine the satisfying chaos of falling sand simulations with the structure and strategy of Tetris? Well, you got that, Sand Tetris. And trust me, it's a lot more chaotic than it looks. The idea for this game actually came from YouTube channel The Coding Train. If you have ever seen Daniel Schiffman's Coding Challenge 180, you will know how addictive those sand simulations can be. I saw that video and thought, okay, this is cool, but what if we took it to the next level? What if we added Tetris? So I went down to the rabbit hole, explored similar games online, and finally decided to create my own version. But before we dive into the game itself, let's talk about what makes it tick. The backstory, cellular automata. If you have never heard of it, don't worry. It sounds fancy, but it's actually a pretty simple concept. Imagine a grid where each cell follows a set of rules based on its neighbors. These rules decide whether a cell is alive, dead, or in our case, just a grain of sand minding its own business. The whole idea is to simulate complex behavior using really simple rules. For example, in my game, if a grain of sand is above an empty space, it falls down. If there is no space directly below it, it tries to slide to the sides. And if everything's blocked, well, it just stays there and gives up on life. And that's how cellular automata works. Simple, right? But trust me, when you scale it up to thousands of particles, it turns into absolute chaos. Which is why I spent more time debugging sand than I would like to admit. Let's start with the basics, the grid system. In Sand Tetris, everything revolves around the grid. It's like the backbone of the game. To create this, I wrote a script called gridmanager.cs. The script is responsible for initializing the grid and managing its values. Here how it works. I defined a 2D array to represent the grid. Each cell in this array holds information about whether it's empty, fill it with sand, or a part of a Tetris block. Then, visualize this grid in Unity, I used a prefab with a sprite render component. For each cell in the grid, I instantiate this prefab, so the grid appears as a collection of individual squares in the scene. This setup might look simple, but it's super flexible and allows us to update the grid dynamically as the game progresses. Now that we have a grid, let's talk about the sand physics. This is where things start to get really fun. I implemented a method in gridmanager.cs called updateGrid, which handles all the sand behavior. The basic idea is this. For every grain of sand, the script checks if the cell below is empty. And if it is, the sand falls down. And if the cell below is occupied, it tries to slide to the left or the right. Here is the code for that. You can see I have added a few simple conditions to check the cell below, left and right. If cell under the sand is empty, the sand flows there. If the cell below it is full, but the cell to the its right or left is empty, then it flows there. This gives the illusion of realistic sand physics. Of course, if the sand can't move anywhere, it just stays in place. With the sand physics done, I moved on to the Tetris mechanics. For this, I created another script called TetrisManager.cs. This script handles everything related to the Tetris blocks, spawning them, moving them, and checking for completed rows. Whenever a row is completely filled, I use a float fill algorithm to clear the blocks. Here is how that works. The algorithm starts for each filled cell in the row, marks all connected cells, and removes them from the grid. I think it's not working well enough right now, but the problems can definitely be solved with improvements. And just like that, the blocks disappear. It is incredibly satisfying to watch. Also, the clear rows are replaced with sand particles, so the chaos never really ends. I hit some bugs when coding areas where the sand changed. This visuality emerges when float fill works correctly, but only when it works correctly. Alright, enough talking. Let's see Sand Tetris in action. You can see here how the sand particles cascade down the grid with a somewhat realistic flow. It feels almost alive, right? And then, as I drop a Tetris block, you can see how it integrates with the mechanics. It's chaotic, but that is the charm. This is where the game really stands out. Balancing the Tetris mechanics with the unpredictability of sand physics creates a truly unique gameplay experience. Sometimes flowing sand can ruin your entire plan, and trust me, it gets harder the longer you play. Of course, this is just the beginning. In the future, I would love to add features like different types of sand, maybe some that explode, stick together, or even disappear over time. And maybe, just maybe, I will experiment with the dynamic obstacles or levels that change as you play. If you want to try Sand Tetris for yourself or dive into the code, you can find the project on my GitHub. The link's in the description below. Feel free to explore, play, or even contribute. Because who knows, maybe your idea could make this game even better. I hope you enjoyed watching me bring this chaotic little game to life. If you liked it, let me know in the comments. Tell me what you think or suggest features you would like to see in the future. And hey, if you are into fun programming projects like this, consider subscribing. I have got plenty more ideas in the pipeline. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.